Hello guys, welcome to UNC virtual class. I am Pragyalin Sahu, department belongs from IT, that is computer science, from UN Autonomous College, Science and Technology, Odaspur, Cuttack. Today I am going to discuss about the concept of microprocessors. So here is an outlines which will I discuss on today's, that's your micro, then second one is the processors, then the third one is the microprocessor, and the next one is the evolution of microprocessor, and the last one is the distinguish between microprocessor and processors. So first of all, to start the concept of microprocessors, as we know, the microprocessor to be comes by using two combinational words. One is the micro and another one is the processors. So what is the term of micro? As we know, the micro means small in size. That means when the micro keywords to be embedded with any object, here the object to be looks like very small and tiny, that is to be called as micro. Then now goes to the next term, that's your processors. As we know, the processor is one of the most functional component part of the computer systems. That means the main function of the processors to be processing all over the data which is on the format of binary codes, that is zeros and ones, through instruction which is stored in between your memory, that is to be called as processors. Normally this processor to be designing by consisting millions number of transistors, so that sometimes this given processor to be called as brain of the computers and also motherboard of the computers. Why it is to be called as brain of the computers and motherboard of the computers? Because as all over the activity which is to be performed in between your computer systems, all over the internal activity to be controlled by the given processors, so that it is to be called as brain of the computers. Now goes to our main goal part, that's your microprocessors. So what is microprocessors? Generally, the microprocessor is a circuit which surrounds the processors. That means the microprocessor to be normally designing by consisting multiple number of transistors, multiple numbers of different processors, diodes, registers, which all have to be entailed together into a single integrated chip, which is to be normally works like your versatile nature. This is to be called as microprocessors. In single statements, if we says the microprocessor is one type of electronical chip which is to be performed as the multi-purpose functions through which the end user to be very easily performing different types of job executions, this is to be called as microprocessor. For example, in case of microprocessors, all over the Android phones and also the remote systems of the any types of remote systems, that's the example of microprocessors. Now goes to the next concept, that's your evolution of microprocessor. Initially, the microprocessor to be designed by the Intel corporations on year 1971, this microprocessor to be normally called as Intel 4004. This processors normally to be executed single purpose job executions. That means it only perform all over the arithmetical operations like your addition and subtractions, and some logical manipulations, that's your boolean OR and boolean AND manipulations. But when this given processor to be executed any types of job, here every instruction word size formats by default 4 bit formats. After that, another one new microprocessor to be evolved on year 1973 by also Intel corporations, that is to be called as Intel 8008. This processor is similar as Intel 4004, but whenever we have to execute all over the instructions, here all over the instruction word size by default 8 bit format, but it only executes the arithmetical data manipulation like your addition subtractions and also logical and or operations. After that, in 1978, a new powerful microprocessor to be designed by the Intel corporations, that is to be called as Intel 8086. Intel 8086, which is to be performing every types of arithmetical logical data manipulations like your addition, subtraction, multiplications, divisions, modulus, logical and or not, all over the different types of arithmetical and logical data to be executed. But here one disadvantage is to be occurs, the Intel 8086 to be executed whenever any instructions, here each word size by default, that's your 16 bit format. When this Intel 8086 to be needed for executing any types of commercial data applications, that can be possible. So finally, on year 1983, the Intel Corporations to be provide some Pentium microprocessors, that's your Pentium 8086 advanced version of Intel 8086, and another microprocessor, that's your 8085, through which different types of commercial applications to be executed in different ways. That means here the microprocessor 8085 and advanced 8086 to be support different types of data execution in versatile ways. So this is all over about concept, the evolution of microprocessors. Now goes to the next part, that should distinguish between Intel microprocessors and also the processors. What is the difference? In case of processor, as we know, the processor to be normally designing by consisting millions number of transistors. But in case of microprocessors, to be designing by consisting this given processor with other processors. Then now goes to the second difference. Generally, the processor always to be provides single purpose of executions. That means, as we know, the processor to be contains two components, one is the ALU and another one is the control unit, so that it only perform the arithmetical and logical manipulation by using some constraint, by using some conditions, by using some protocols through CU. But the microprocessor is multi-purpose in nature. That means, here the microprocessor to be provides different types of job we have to execute it simultaneously. How? Because in case of microprocessor to be contains the processors with some other extra processor. That means, for examples, suppose the end user to be needed for executing any types of arithmetical job calculations, that to be possible by using your processors as well as the microprocessor, because the microprocessor holds the CPU. But if another user to be needs for executing any types of graphical data manipulation or any types of client server manipulations, that can be possible by using your processors. But that to be possible by using your microprocessor. How? As we know, the microprocessor to be hold some other processor like your graphics processor, through which graphics data to be manipulated. It holds some network card through which the client server communication to be possible above the connection of internet. It holds some multimedia sound audio cards through which different types of multimedia applications we have to execute it. That can be possible in case of processors. Now goes to the next difference. In case of processor, as it executed only single purpose, only arithmetical logical manipulations, so here the CPU job execution is very fast. That means the CPU throughput in this case is very high. But in case of microprocessors, the throughput is very less. Why? In this case, as the microprocessor to be executed different types of data, that to be executed as the function CPU to be provides and also other processor job to be executed. So that here the CPU throughput is less as compared to processors. Now goes to the next difference. Here in case of processor, when we have to started the job executions, here all over the input output peripheral elements and transistor to be open the switch gate. So when all over the job to be executed properly, then the transistor to be switch up the all over the input output peripheral elements. So here the electricity to be consumes much more. But if this given job to be executed by the help of microprocessor, here the electricity consumes very less. How? In case of microprocessors, it provides one facilities. If any one of the input output peripheral elements that will finish its works, then it automatically switch off the particular input output peripheral elements. So that here the electricity to be consumes very less as compared to in case of processors. Now goes to the next difference. The CPU always to be called as main part of the computers. Why? As we know, in case of computer systems, when first initially it to be developed, it normally to be used for the calculatings. So the calculation to be possible by using the arithmetical and logical operators. So as the CPU to be provides arithmetical logical unit and also control units, so the CPU always main part of the computer systems. But here the microprocessor is one type of chip of the computer systems which surrounds the processors. That means here it is one type of chip. Now goes to the last difference in between your processor to microprocessor. Every processor can be called as microprocessors, but every microprocessor to be called as processor. How? As you know, the microprocessor always contains one sub-component part, that's your CPU. So that every microprocessor to be called as processor, but every processor can be called as microprocessor. So this is all about the today's class. If any doubt or any query to be in your mind, then you can ask me through the comment box. Thank you.